had to leave the classroom for the tour. This is really overwhelming. Thank you, of course, to Shelley's family. I'm so sorry that I'm here and she's not. Thank you to the Webster judges for this honor, and Francis Villa and my crazy English instructors who supported me from the second I walked into that school as an old student to the second. And thank you to my team at the Swarm Chief who are here tonight. They know and I know what I wouldn't be up here without them. And to my husband Michael, who's probably more nervous than me at this moment. and I have to shout out my community of Squamish. It is the most amazing place to live and work. I'm so grateful to be on Squamish Nation territory. And Squamish is a really interesting place that creates these crazy characters. We just lost a really bright light. His name was Tor Rossman. And he built, like with his hands, he built an art gallery and a tea house. And for 50 years, he brought in artists and environmentalists and musicians. And that's the kind of people who like who live and are drawn to Squamish. And I'm so grateful to them for trusting me with their stories. But the locals would tell me that Squamish is full, so please don't go. I wanted to talk a bit about what Shelley meant to me in terms of community journalism. I swear I read everything she ever did. And what I love so much is that even though you learned something every single thing she wrote, you never felt talked down to. And she knew that she was writing with her, that she was covering things with her readers, not at them or to them. I think she got before a lot of us that our job is to sort of reflect our community and give people what they care about, not what we think they should care about. And so that's what Shelley taught me. And while I totally don't feel worthy of this at all, I'll take Shelley with me and try to be.
Yeah.